For tuning in once more, this is Media to Africa. We are really call on you to stay tuned because we having a group of people who have really surrendered their plight for the plight of other people. These are people who have a heart of gold, a large heart. They want to reach to the needy, and they are doing a whole great job there by putting hand on deck to make sure that they raise funds to make sure they go to the people who need, especially in rural Africa. This great team has been doing this work for since like 4 years to date, and they have been organizing and going around Africa and getting in touch with the needy, so it's subsidizing the poverty, the whole lot of African problems that everybody knows that has to do with poverty and rural kind of issues. This team has been working hand in hand as a team just to make sure, as they work in a synergy to raise funds to make sure that they go to support the people who are desperately in need, either to survive socially or to meet up with economic demands. This great team today has sent me 2 representatives who will give us 15 minutes of intense information. They will tell us of the many things they've been doing that I can't really enumerate them because I'm not well versed on all their activities. I'm very happy today to host them to entertain you people with information that is selfless, what they've been doing to the people, the masses out there. Today, welcome, Anne Fouché, you're welcome to my platform.
Thank you, sir.
I think you will have the opportunity to explain, let the public know what you're doing, who you are, and how long you've been existing. Before I come to you, I want to take your co-panelist, sois le bienvenu.
Merci.
Ambassadeur de Bruyé, moi je m'exprime ici officiellement en anglais. De temps en temps, je vais un peu chuter pour pouvoir peut-être vous mettre en ligne. Et je peux poser une question en anglais et vous répondez en français, pas de problème. Le pays est pratiquement bilingue. On va se battre comme ça. Merci, sois le bienvenu encore.
Merci de m'accueillir dans ce merveilleux plateau.
D'accord. Dear Sister Anne, we are happy with what you're doing, and we look up to hear a whole lot of what you're doing because we are not well versed. We just know anytime your name comes up anywhere, we just know something great is happening. Those who need people, those who need help, they're always like, oh, our mom, you are like the mother, like that bread basket of those who don't have. So you have this opportunity to tell the world who you are.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Media Day, for having us again. This is the 3rd time we are here talking about our mission, our vision. We are representing the Sarah Rebecca Foundation, which mission is to foster the health and education of the underprivileged orphans in Africa. This is something we've been doing for 4 years, but we were in Africa in May, and we visited some orphanages where we did donation as usual, and the problems were overwhelming. You know, you saw a lot of kids, like United Nation or UNICEF right now is saying there are 52 million orphans in the entire Africa. We felt the need that we have to engage the community and come up with sustainable solutions to this problem. We can't just sit back and say somebody else will do it for us. We are Africans, in the diaspora. Whatever we come together and make it happen, you know, we elevate some of these socio-economic problems. So that's why we came back with the group, and we came up with the Soiree Black and White, because we had to come with something that can pull out the DMV crowd. We know it's a very tough crowd to pull out. They want to make sure that what you're getting them out of their homes is something that worth it. And they were out there. We want to use the opportunity to thank DMV for coming out on October 19 to support us for this great cause. And we are here today to talk about our upcoming visit to Africa, two African countries, which is specifically Cameroon and Nigeria, to do the official donations. Thank you for having me.
Wow, that's great. So do you have like a physical office? Are you based somewhere physically before going around?
Yes, actually, right now the office is in Germantown. That's where we have a location.
Okay.
But in the years to come, we're planning to open more offices around the countries. We are actually planning to open an office in Nigeria.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And Cameroon, we have like a satellite office, like we call it.
Oh, that's great. Chef, me tourner vers vous. Comment fonctionnez-vous?
Comme Adama a dit tantôt, ça fait 4 ans que nous avons notre fondation Mama Sarah et Rebecca, qui supporte les enfants et les démunis en Afrique. Et nous voulons expatrier de par le monde. Donc cette année, nous avons décidé avec notre fondation de faire une soirée Black and White pour encore élargir notre champ d'aide à travers tous ces enfants qui souffrent. Donc notre vision vraiment c'est de promouvoir l'aide sociale à tous les niveaux pour que ces enfants puissent aller à l'école, puissent avoir une formation académique.
Mm-hmm.
Voilà.
Can I just jump in there? Just add on what Mr. Fotwe said. We actually function with couple of orphanages in Africa.
Yeah.
We contact them, we ask what they need at that time of the year, and they actually give us, you know, some of this problem. Like I said, when we went out there, we discovered that education and health is something that they are lacking at.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have people that come in and give food and clothing, but these kids are out there, they are not going to school. When we talk about sustainable solutions, if you educate somebody, you've already planned their future.
Sure.
Instead of just giving them a rice or food to eat.
Mm-hmm.
So we contact these orphanages, and then we donate. You know, this year we are planning to give 20 scholarships to kids.
Okay.
in those schools. So we go out there, contact them, find out what are their problems, and then we now help them by donating towards that particular problem.
Okay. Elle vient de dire, comme vous aviez choisi le Nigeria et le Cameroun, comment avez-vous fait pour arriver à choisir le Nigeria et le Cameroun?
Merci pour la question. En fait, madame, avant que nous soyons ensemble pour cette cause,
mm-hmm.
madame avait déjà une formation au Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
Donc, d'un commun accord, nous avons décidé de joindre cette formation nigériane
mm-hmm.
à celle du Cameroun pour en faire une, pour pouvoir ensemble travailler pour l'éducation pour tous ces enfants en Afrique.
Ok, thank you, merci pour ça.
And I'll add on Nigeria, specifically mm-hmm. I am the MD and the co-founder of the African Gas Association,
mm-hmm.
and our corporate social responsibility is giving back to those communities that the oil and gas is being exploited. And as one of the co-founders, I insisted that this billionaires should give back to those communities. So that's how, you know, my engagement with Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked a lot with the Nigerian government, where I realized that by me working with Nigerian government, the only thing I can give back to the community was giving back to the social corporate responsibility, which is through the orphanages.
Mm-hmm.
So I did a lot of donation through orphanages in Nigeria. So it is in that line that the Sarah Rebecca Foundation has its route to go to those orphanages in Nigeria to do those donations.
Okay. So I understand you had a press conference before, prior to coming over here. When did that press conference hold, and what was the talk?
Okay, yeah. The press conference that we are having is coming up, actually.
Oh, okay.
It's going to be
okay.
In a couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. It's going to be in Cameroon. And during that press conference, we are planning to kind of spell out our program that we're going to run in Africa, in those two countries. So we are transparent. We like accountability. Mm-hmm. So that press conference, we're going to give the population when, the time, and what are the orphanages that we are doing those donations, and which medias that are going to follow us, mm-hmm. both in Cameroon and in Nigeria.
Okay, we always do the pleasure to say hi to our viewers. We have Francoise DeWitt Juno, who's watching. I have my younger brother, Briton Coco, who's watching all the way from Kumba. Then we have behind our machine technical dashboard, we have Jules Kamfoud Lati, and this is the program that is spearheaded by our, we fondly call him Prezi Le Marécial, and we worked hand in hand with Prezi Le Marécial, and we have also Honoré Fomkong. This is a great team that we stand behind to push projects like this ahead, and we love what they are doing. That's why we're doing our best to make sure we push you people.
Thank you.
You continue to spread your help. So before going to Cameroon, you've been existing for 4 years now. Which other countries did you visit?
Yes, I visited Ghana. Mm-hmm. I was in Ghana, and we do a lot of work in Ghana, and also with Cote d'Ivoire. Mm-hmm. That's why the ambassador of Cote d'Ivoire, His Excellency Mamadou Haidara, mm-hmm. was actually present through Mr. Kone, mm-hmm. during the Soiree Black and White, and they gave donation towards the cause, because last year I was in Abidjan, and I visited the orphanages and made official donation to these countries.
That's really sounding great, because we are of Africa. In like Saudi Arabia, where this is a petroleum-rich world,
correct.
They make sure they contribute to the immediate vicinities.
Correct.
Because like in Limbe or in the Southwest region would have been benefiting some incentives for the fact that the Sonara refinery is planted over there. But we don't have this. So thanks to the groups you people are bringing up and sensitizing the masses, going to the governments to make sure that they put a hand in a little bit of what they make, enormous sums of money, just to see that they support projects like this. I hope the governments have been really pushing you guys.
Yes, Nigeria has been very, very, responsive. Cameroon, I always say it's a zone that I trade. My country, I love it. Mm-hmm. But I think with Cameroon, I realize it's more with the private sector, the parastata. So mm-hmm. you want to be working with Brazzaville, Cameroon. Mm-hmm. We have UBA that's sponsoring us, and also BVS.
Okay.
So we want to go through those private companies. Sonara, I know, but mm-hmm. I'll leave them for right now. But Nigeria,
yeah.
we have those Eto Oil and Gas. We have a lot of my member companies that, get in and put in money to support those orphanages in Nigeria. And like I said, we all know they are exploiting this oil and gas. Mm-hmm. What about the infrastructure? They don't have roads. They don't have schools. They don't have hospitals.
Yeah.
So if you guys have those structural corporate social responsibility programs, mm-hmm. I don't see you guys doing it. So that's the part I push more mm-hmm. with my association.
Okay. Bien dit, nous dit par rapport à soi-disant la conférence de presse qui aura lieu d'ici quelque peu. Quel serait le but de conférence de presse que vous aurez en place?
Ouais, merci pour la question, M. Modeste. Notre conférence de presse, c'est pour interpeller les mécènes, mm-hmm. c'est pour interpeller les philanthropes mm-hmm. de nous accompagner dans cette bonne cause que nous mm-hmm. supportons depuis 4 ans.
Ok. Donc, à part cette conférence de presse, quels sont d'autres projets en ligne? Comme vous maintenant la priorité, c'est d'aller au Nigeria et au Cameroun. Et c'est dans quel mois?
C'est le mois de décembre.
Ah, décembre.
Et après notre conférence de presse, nous avons prévu de faire des dons dans le littoral, mm-hmm. à l'ouest,
okay.
et au sud-ouest,
mm-hmm.
et bien sûr accompagné par les brasseries du Cameroun, parce que les brasseries du Cameroun sont nos spéciales sponsors depuis plus de 4 ans, mm-hmm. qui nous accompagnent dans cette aventure.
Okay.
Et nous voulons vraiment leur dire merci pour ça, pour tout le soutien, pour tout ce qu'ils font pour ces enfants.
Je vous souhaite vraiment bonne chance pour cette cause, pour qu'un jour vous arriverez au moins en Kambé. Je suis sortisan d'un Kambé, très loin dans le nord-ouest, dans le Donganmantum. Ils ont aussi besoin de vous. Et c'est aussi une façon de vous dire que, avantage des services, que je mets aussi le nom d'un Kambé où je sors en ligne pour que vous sachiez qu'il y a aussi un département qui a besoin de vous. I think you have a whole lot again to throw on this.
Yes, project. I just want to trace about the three provinces that we are visiting in Cameroon, because we had to put a thought on that.
Mm-hmm.
Literal, because you have a lot of displaced kids from the northwest and southwest region who are currently in Douala.
Mm-hmm.
So even though we are going to the orphanages, it's not just the orphanages. You guys will be seeing pictures, live videos that we are visiting those internally displaced kids who are in Douala, who've got information that there are a lot of them. So they are coming from the northwest and the southwest. We are visiting the west because we've got information that there are a lot of kids from the northwest that are actually hiding in the West Province.
Yes.
Boya specifically is where we are going in the Southwest. We have to be careful because of the environment right now, you know, in terms of security.
Mm-hmm.
In as much as we want to help there, we have to be very careful.
Sure.
So for now, that's where we're going to start off there. Then later on, we'll see how the atmosphere, the vibrations, once things calm down. Like I said, I would really love to go to Kambé because my junior sister is married to a man from Kambé.
Oh, that's great.
Yes.
You see, that's a kind of connection already.
Yes.
So before we'll be observing a commercial break, at least I'll turn to my brother here who obviously has something to contribute to talk about, at least coming with some of the priorities that you people have on point now, like in the pipeline, a part of going to Cameroon and Nigeria. From Cameroon, Nigeria, où irez-vous après le projet du Cameroun et du Nigeria? Comment choisirez-vous l'autre place où vous y aller ou l'autre pays?
Ça c'est une très très bonne question. En fait, nous ne choisissons pas. En fait, ce qu'on fait, c'est que nous avons une plateforme et nous avons toute une équipe qui chaque équipe se charge de visionner et de sélectionner les orphelins qui ont besoin d'aide. Comment dire, nous supportons toute l'Afrique, c'est pas seulement le Cameroun. Donc s'il y a un pays comme le Ghana qui est ou bien le Nigeria ou le Mozambique ou la Sierra Leone, nous sommes ouverts pour aller dans tous ces pays parce que là-bas il y a beaucoup d'enfants qui n'ont pas d'eau potable. Donc nous sommes ouverts à tous les projets pour pouvoir venir en aide.
Ok, merci. Avant qu'on on observe la pause publicitaire, je profite pour dire un grand coucou à Honoré qui n'est pas en place, à mon host, et aussi le Maricia avec le projet. The successful project of Africa Awards of Washington that just ended on the 30th of November. It was so hectic. I say a big thank you to those who participated in this project, who supported this project, and it really gave value to what it has been talking. So at least people who had the opportunity to win the deposit in all the specific groups where they were nominated, they at least went home happy people. And next year, same event will be coming up. So we'll be going for a commercial break. You surely have 1 minute to say something.
Yeah, 1 minute only. I just want to thank again the entire DMV and the United States population that supported us, and also to say that just in prospect, we have the second edition of the Soiree Black and White coming on October 17, 2020.
Okay.
And I really want to thank Media Day for being not a very big partner to the Soiree Black and White.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be going for a commercial break. It might take 2 minutes. We thank you for staying tuned, and we just hold you. Stay tuned, because after this, we'll be coming in with very strong points again. Commercial.
Kale, 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 kale. Kale, 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 kale. Oh, papi. Kale, 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 kale. Letting out my emotions. Boy, you're driving me crazy. Set my heart in motion, the way it's mine for a lady. Je veux que tu know, que je t'aime. Il me manque des mots pour te dire je t'aime. If you ask me a question, boy, I give you the answer. Attendu que je vous fasse. Que tu nous que je t'aime. Il me manque de mots pour te dire je t'aime. Cette fois je suis calé, oh, je suis calé. Hélas je suis calé, oh, je suis calé. Le calme tu avais son regard. Je suis calé. Les risques conséquences je m'en fous. Je suis calé. Façon tu me touches, façon tu me veux tu es maman. I know that you love me, mais je t'aime plus fort. I know that you need me, but I need you more. If you ask me a question, boy I give you the answer. Attends que je for so long, and I hope you remember. Mais est-ce que tu know, oh, que je t'aime. Il me manque de mots.
Ensemble, lèvons-nous pour célébrer la fin d'année 2019 avec la communauté Onkem des États-Unis. Samedi 28 décembre 2019, de 19h à 4h du matin, au Hampton Conference Center, adresse 207 W Hampton Place, Capitol Heights, Maryland. Tickets disponibles, $70, $100 et $150. Contact 240-665-87-59, 202-288-71-75, 240-863-53-40.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for staying connected. As we promised, after the commercial break, we'll be bringing some two strong gentlemen who are also doing a whole lot. These are Cameroonians in the diaspora who are putting hand on deck, making sure that they give back to the community back in Cameroon through the other kind of projects they organize here. Here we have people from the division of Onkam in the Western Province. We have Mr.
Zile Michel,
and we have Apollinaire over here. These two gentlemen here will take the short time we have here to make sure that they spread the news, they give the information concerning the projects they have in the pipeline, looking up to go back to come around and give to the community. So they are out here working themselves out, making sure that they stay connected to restaurants, go back home and do something to their communities. It's a kind of acknowledging where they come from. This program will be a bilingual one, interactive, because these two gentlemen here, they speak French, though they speak English too, but they will better express themselves in French. So I was struggling with my French, why they do well in their French. Moment I will push them to come back to English. Mr. Zele, bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
Yeah. Quel est le projet maintenant que vous avez en main pour pouvoir entamer pour, peut-être on m'a parlé des projets que vous aviez concernant le département de Onkam dans l'ouest, n'est-ce pas, l'ouest
oui,
Cameroun.
Oui,
okay.
Effectivement.
Oui, vous pouvez au moins dire au public qui nous suit ici le projet que vous avez en main concernant le département de Onkam.
Oui, en fait nous avons généralement beaucoup de projets pour notre département parce que nous sommes de la diaspora, et quand on parle de la diaspora, la diaspora est là parfois pour essayer de réfléchir sur les différents projets qu'ils peuvent faire pour encourager et promouvoir le développement dans leur département. Mm-hmm. Mais en fait, ici, ce soir, nous sommes là pour parler, parce que nous avons essayé penser à organiser une fête comme nous l'avons toujours fait tous les ans, mm-hmm. avec l'association Onkam, mm-hmm. De Maryland,
dans le DMV
en mm-hmm. général. Chaque année, on organise une fête de fin d'année. À partir de cette fête de fin d'année, nous pouvons parfois, non seulement c'est pour distraire, pour permettre la réjouissance à la population mm-hmm. onkamoise et associée à tous les autres Camerounais, mm-hmm. mais également parfois nous avons les récoltes que nous faisons de ces projets, de ces fêtes nous aident à organiser parfois des projets, comme mm-hmm. vous avez dit, pour okay. notre communauté.
Mm-hmm. Donc, tous les gens, les ressortissants de Onkam, tous les Camerounais, les Africains qui sont basés ici dans le DMV. DMV, c'est, ça veut dire le Washington District of Columbia, Maryland et Virginia. Because these three states are the kind of very interconnected and not far from each other, that is why we put them together anytime there's an event, be it in Maryland or DC or Virginia. Both from the three states are invited because it takes just like perhaps 5 minutes to connect. So everybody from Cameroon, Africa in general, who lives here in America, are invited to this show. So I'll be turning to Apollinaire, who, bonsoir encore. Je pense que maintenant...
Comment vous appelez?
Moi, je me nomme Modeste.
Bonsoir Modeste, c'est un plaisir partagé pour moi d'être ici ce soir. Commencerai par remercier mm-hmm. tous ceux qui nous regardent.
Okay.
Je remercie toute la communauté du Onkam. Yeah. Je remercie tous les téléspectateurs qui nous regardent actuellement, tous ces braves femmes et les hommes du Onkam qui nous regardent. Alors, je commencerai par vous dire que dans le Onkam, nous avons beaucoup de projets humanitaires, n'est-ce okay. pas? Mm-hmm. Nous soutenons la communauté sur tous les plans. Mais ce qui nous amène ici ce soir, mm-hmm. effectivement, c'est, n'est-ce pas, notre fête de fin d'année.
Okay.
Et vous savez, cette fête sera exceptionnelle. Exceptionnelle parce que nous allons profiter de sa lancée, de ce jour-là, pour supporter, n'est-ce pas, les enfants déplacés de la crise anglophone. Okay. Vous savez, le Cameroun est en proie à une grave crise humanitaire sans précédent. Et c'est l'occasion pour nous, n'est-ce pas, de pouvoir réunir les fonds, n'est-ce pas, et pouvoir supporter les enfants déplacés du Nozo. Vous savez, c'est humanitaire ce que nous voulons faire. Et nous sommes ici ce soir pour demander la communauté, n'est-ce pas, de venir nous soutenir. C'est-à-dire, nous demandons que les gens achètent massivement les billets, que les gens se mobilisent. Parce que, vous savez, pour une cause humanitaire, l'union doit faire la force. Vous savez, nous voulons mobiliser tous les gens de notre communauté à mettre la main dessus, à acheter leurs billets, n'est-ce pas, à appeler les numéros qui sont sur les flyers afin qu'ensemble, nous puissions, n'est-ce pas, mener à bien cette œuvre grandiose, cette œuvre humanitaire sans précédent.
Okay.
Donc, je vais essayer de venir dans les plus dans les petits détails.
Dans les minutes qui suivent. Je profite aussi pour dire un petit coucou au suivant. Je vois mon boss, Honoré Fomukon, qui dit good job, maestro. Thank you for the training, Honoré. We have Linless Soufre Brenda. We also have Agnes Ndumam Mbiai. Who are watching all the way, I don't know, they didn't give their destinations. We have Maestro Chakuta. So we say hi to you guys watching over there. Spread the news, share, so you follow your fellow friends also can follow the platform. There is an end of year event that's coming in the ONCAM, the division of ONCAM in the West Province. They have a whole big project, a project that is really large, that is really calling everybody, every Cameroonian, to come support them, not only people from ONCAM, because this is a project that is targeting to support people who are internally displaced and people who are already caught up with the crisis that is taking place in Cameroon. We know Cameroon now has been suffering from a lot of political chaos for the past 3 years. So these are sons of the soils, people from Cameroon who are serveless. They have decided to do everything, put hand on deck to see that they can help those who are internally displaced, those who are suffering from the crisis. So this really a cause to support. We're calling you who are watching to take appointment with them. Flyers will be shared, be on the event, and put your hands in your pocket to support this project. I'm sure Apollinaire will be giving details again about this coming up event that they are programming to see that they raise funds to target that project. Apollinaire, je pense que vous allez éclairer le peuple en détail.
Merci, merci Modeste. Premièrement, j'aimerais parler d'abord la symbolique de cette fête pour le ONCAM.
Okay.
Vous savez, c'est une tradition annuelle. Chaque année ou bien tous les deux ans, n'est-ce pas, la communauté du ONCAM s'est réunie, n'est-ce pas, pour célébrer la fin d'année en beauté. N'est-ce pas, c'est l'occasion pour nous de partager le vivre ensemble avec la communauté. C'est l'occasion pour nous de s'aimer l'amour dans la communauté, n'est-ce pas, de dialoguer. C'est aussi l'occasion pour nous d'évaluer le bilan de notre parcours. Vous savez, notre nouveau bureau a été en place depuis mars. Mm-hmm. Donc, nous sommes à décembre, donc nous allons un peu évaluer, n'est-ce pas, ce qu'on a fait jusqu'à là. Et puis, exceptionnellement, je vous parlais donc, c'est la crise dans le Nord-Ouest qui nous intéresse. Donc, cette fête qui aura lieu le 28 décembre sera accentuée sur la crise du Nozo.
Okay.
Donc, comme je vous parlais de la symbolique de la fête, donc c'est une fête, c'est la fête de la communauté. C'est une fête réjouissance communautaire. Nous fêtons le partage. C'est ça la symbolique, l'amour dans la communauté du ONCAM. Okay. C'est-à-dire que nous nous réunissons avec les sympathisants, les amis et sympathisants, nos sponsors, pour fêter en beauté la fin d'année.
Merci. Il y a Aude Nkamoussa qui nous dit bonsoir à tous. Bonsoir à toi aussi. Partage pour que tes amis puissent suivre. Je vais me tourner vers vous. Vous fonctionnez, ça fait déjà combien d'années?
En fait, comme a dit le frère tout à l'heure, le ONCAM est là depuis une trentaine d'années.
Ok.
Donc, c'est au moins une trentaine d'années que cette association a été installée dans le DMV. Mm-hmm. Et depuis lors, nous fonctionnons. C'est vrai que il y a parfois des gens qui ont cru que nous avons que le Honkam est divisé, mais en fait, non. Mm-hmm. Nous ne sommes pas divisés parce qu'en fait, nous travaillons tous pour la même communauté.
Mm-hmm.
Et les gens, quels qu'ils soient, s'ils veulent travailler d'une manière, mm-hmm. apporter leur façon de faire pour le Honkam, mm-hmm. C'est normal, c'est mm-hmm. tout à fait normal. Parce que, mais ça nous permet tout simplement de soutenir ensemble notre communauté. Et, cette fois-ci où nous avons donc ce problème qui est de vivre ensemble mm-hmm. et ces déplacés mm-hmm. Qui sont dans nos arrivés là avec les enfants, surtout mm-hmm. qu'il faut que les enfants aillent à l'école, nous avons décidé donc de cette année de donner cette couleur spéciale à notre événement. Donc okay. Toutes les années que nous avons vécu, nous avons tenté d'organiser cette fête de fin d'année mm-hmm. pour le vivre ensemble, pour partager avec les autres communautés camerounaises, africaines, vivant dans le DMV.
Okay, that's good. Before I go ahead, I'll have to acknowledge the good job message from my team, Media to Africa, just said, good job, Modest. At least when you do a good job and your boss acknowledges, that will be a good kind of compliment. I want to talk about this vivre ensemble that my two gentlemen have said on the platform here. If we have to say the closest provinces that is connected to the Northwest and Southwest in respect of this connection cultural-wise is the Western province. Mm-hmm. Like they used to say, Lingrafi, the grass field.
Yeah,
this is a West province and the Northwest province caught together. Province. So vivre ensemble, if somebody has to talk about living together, it's somebody from the Western province. Because the fallouts of the crisis from the Northwest and Southwest, West province suffers the consequences too.
Yes.
Because the internally displaced people, the first place to seek refuge is in the Western province. Because first of all, it's kind of the breadbasket of Cameroon too. It's the economic backwire of Cameroon because of the opportunities that that's kind of similar to what people from the Northwest and